it was not done without consultation from the people. We have heard the outcries of the citizenry, especially here in Belize City, where, as you know, I'm a Belize City representative, and there have been many suggestions in line of that. In fact, you know that some time ago there were measures that Prime Minister Esquivel tried to put in, Prime Minister Barra, sorry, tried to put in, having to do with preventative detention. And we heard people loud and clear. It was a different climate, it was a different time. I think the rate of murders have since then gone up tremendously, and there were many people who said, you know, we need that kind of measure, although that is not, it's not the same thing. And to tell you the facts, the truth is that the measures that have been put in place to declare those zones in an emergency state did not just come while I was acting Prime Minister. You'll remember in March when we had another terrible spate of murders, that decision was announced. All that happened, the government was full of restraint and in fact did not move to declare the particular zones. And after a little while, when things calmed down, we thought that we'd just hold off until things flared up, and we saw the absolute need to do it. And last weekend was, in fact, that opportunity where we thought that it was absolutely necessary. And by and large, I think what is happening now in terms of the lack of the murders now, at least those that are directly connected with the gangs and with the drugs and all of that, very minimal now compared to what we ought to, we would have had if that measure was not in place. I believe it is a positive measure on the part of the government. There are many people in the society who are saying that as well. I understand all of those who are saying or who are complaining about it being against human rights and all of that, but when the entire society is being held ransom by just a few, then I think drastic times does indeed call for drastic measures.